Wake up, neighboring businesses in beautiful downtown Kearney Mesa. It's time for Throttle Thursday. I love this. Oh my goodness gracious. It's Throttle Thursday. We're talking all about transportation that is eco-friendly, perfect for the greens as well. Brian Rott from Cart Mart. I love these things. Brian, good morning. Thanks for being here, by the way.
Thank you for having me.
And I love the horn on this. It's quite loud, isn't it? It's very cool. Okay, talk to me. What separates what you guys have from the old golf cart that we're all used to on the greens? And my dad used to have a golf cart. Tell me the difference between these things.
Well, nowadays there's a complete disparity between what is a golf car and what's a vehicle for the street. And this technology, the evolution of the golf car has come so far from being a simple golf vehicle to a passenger car to move people on the roads.
This thing that we're showing you now is incredible. It's like a car. You said you can take this on the road? Because you got your surfboard on top, right?
Exactly.
And you got the horn, you got the mirrors, everything else. What is on this golf cart that makes it different from anything else?
Well, for starters, it's not a golf cart. It's designed by DOT as a low-speed vehicle for street use. So this is traditionally not allowed on a golf course. It's for street use, whereas some of the vehicles we make are specific to golf.
Okay, now why electric? Because some of the golf carts have other engines that are not. Why electric, for example?
Well, electric is probably the most popular in California, of course. But just for the eco-friendly and power, torque, cost of use and ownership, and certainly electric is a lot more fun to drive than gas.
People love classic cars. Do people love classic golf carts?
It's becoming more and more popular, as a matter of fact. We have our restored vehicle here that we brought down from the National Museum of Golf Cars in Rancho.
So this you know, I used to work in Palm Springs, so I drove by that museum all the time, and we did stories on golf carts all the time in Palm Springs. And tell me what we're looking at here. What is this?
This is a 1960s era Turf Rider 4. This was built and used on used on the golf course predominantly. Nowadays, they're completely used for moving people and stuff.
So cool.
But this is a fully restored 1960s era golf cart.
Now, in Palm Springs, the big deal is you see a lot of golf carts on the street, like we were talking about street legal and this and that. What makes a golf cart street legal?
So it's actually, there's no such thing as a street legal golf cart.
Oh, in fact, I like all these little intricacies. Yeah. So we're learning a lot.
We call them street illegal golf carts.
Street illegal?
Because you're either a low speed vehicle that's designed for the use, or you're a golf cart designed for the golf course. And so technology, which is
breaking
safety features.
Okay, so here's the deal. What recommendations would you have? Someone's looking for a golf cart, maybe an LSV. What do you tell them? What do they need to look for? Like, look at our my man DJ J-Flex is here, and he's driving around. So what do you look for? Like, what do you know what you want? Do you have to live in a golf course? You don't.
You can live in the rural community. You can live on a golf course. We basically start with what's your needs? What are you trying to accomplish? Where are you going with it? And so once we start with that, we build what you need.
This is a beauty. You have the keys. Why don't you take me first? I'm scared. I got to drive it? Oh my God. Okay, fine. Let's get all the information. Cart Mart. All the information is on our website, fox5sandiego.com. Here, hold my cards. Very important.
All right.
Brian. All right. Okay, ready?
Take it out of neutral.
Okay, put this on brake. Put the brake thing down. There we go.
Pouring forward. And you're good.
That's it. Don't hit photographer Alan. Here we go. Oh, yeah, Nelly. Okay, everybody. Throttle Thursday, a little bit quiet today, but that's okay. There was a time I could have gone into the studio.
Time now for your morning weather, powered by Jerome.